For the Transatlantic Climate Bridge Project, our group worked together on composting or the eco-friendly disposal of organic garbage. On the Ohio side, Bethany, Lauren and Kyle contributed to the international project, while Maria, Saskia, Elisabeth and Sandro worked on the German side. For our environment, it is immensely important to find sustainable ways of disposing garbage in order to keep the planet clean. To make a first step, we focused on organic garbage because it provides already simple solutions such as composting. Another motivation for choosing this topic was the omnipresence of the problem of waste disposal. Because in both universities, the Ohio University and the University of Leipzig, large amounts of organic garbage are produced in canteens or cafeterias, this theme bridges not only both universities but both nations.
Composting is the natural decomposition of organic material such as food waste, yard trimmings, or manure. The resulting matter has several uses as a fertilizer. The composting facility itself is totally sustainable. The building is powered entirely by solar panels that charge throughout the day and have the ability to overcharge and actually provide power for the main city grid. There's no potable water on site as all rain is collected in an underground storage tank used to rinse out the compost bins once they've been dumped.
On average, 4,000 to 5,000 students eat lunch at the biggest canteen of the University of Leipzig called Mensa am Park per day. The food itself is produced in 5-kilogram portions in order to reduce leftovers. In the kitchen, food scraps from the preparation of meals, such as carrot peels, celery leaves, parsley stems or eggshells, are collected in a container and suctioned into a waste collection tank. After the students finish lunch, their dishes with leftovers on plates are transported via an assembly line into the kitchen. There, leftovers are removed from plates and suctioned into the waste collection tank. This process is at the same time clean and hygienic. The waste collection tank has a capacity of 9 cubic meters, which equals about 2,400 gallons. Dishwater and water from cleaning the kitchen are filtered here. Within 24 hours, about 20 to 40 liters, which equals about 5 to 10 gallons, of oil and small food scraps are filtered out and pumped into the waste collection tank. Food scraps and dishwater are suctioned with the help of a compressor with 8.8 bar. Water gets separated from food scraps. Several tubes transport, for instance, food scraps, filtered oil, mud and liquid waste. On average, about 140,000 cubic meters, which equals about 37 million gallons of so-called organic liquid waste, are collected in the tank per year. About every week, the collected waste is transported to biogas plants, where so-called biogas as a renewable form of energy is released as a product of an anaerobic digestion process. About another 180,000 liters or 47,500 gallons respectively of organic waste are collected annually at the University of Leipzig for instance at additional small canteens or cafeterias. The cleaning department of the city of Leipzig is responsible for picking up this additional organic waste. It is then brought to composting facilities in the greater Leipzig area, for instance in Limena, where one such facility exists since 1998. Tree grass and bush clippings, pieces of plants, and further gardening waste is collected at a composting facility. From such trimmings, the facility produces substrate, which is, for instance, a component of potting soil. Organic waste, such as food scraps, however, is turned into compost. Such compost is used in agriculture as ingredient in topsoil, but also for the recultivation of landscapes. Trimmings first get shredded and are then piled up. Every month these piles are flipped over with the help of wheel loaders. If necessary, they are also watered. After about half a year, the composting process is finished. Then the final product is sifted and made ready to be sold. The composting process at Limena is very natural. This means that no supplements are added, which might help accelerate the process. It is also typical that the process is aerobic, which means that air is getting to the waste. The flipping around, for instance, is necessary to allow enough air to get to the waste. The rotting process is controlled regularly in form of checking of the temperature and the quality of the waste. It is important for the rotting process that the waste is wet, that the material has a certain structure, and that the waste piles do not exceed the height of 1.5 meter. For the watering of the waste piles, rainwater is collected in an open basin. Altogether, about 18 to 19,000 tons, between 40 and 42 million pounds, of material are processed per year. However, during the rotting process, it shrinks and the final compost equals only about one-third of the original input material. Composting in general gains in importance today, because it helps to bring more humus into the soil while saving peat. Moreover, compost can be used as fertilizer, and with that it can replace chemical fertilizer. Problems of composting are that technical challenges have to be met in order to produce a high-quality product. Hand in hand with this goes the question of money, because the technical equipment has to be kept up to date. In addition, the composting process at a facility in Limena is very long, as it takes about half a year until the final compost is produced. The facility in Limena does not use biofuel for operating its machines, but it currently prefers conventional fuels. It is connected to the regular electrical grid without making use of additional renewable energies.